Hello and welcome to Ask Porsche. I'm Alex and this is Andy from Porsche.
Hi.
We're here in the studio in Stuttgart-Zuffenhausen and I will be asking him your questions about this beautiful car, the Taycan, Porsche's first all-electric car.
Put your hand there on the steering wheel and then you can relax.
The Taycan is locally emission-free.
This is how I get the skis in the car.
We are here with Porsche's first all-electric car, the Taycan. The question is about hydrogen though, and I'm sure many people are curious to hear what our expert Andy has to say. So I will read you the question. Okay. Are you going to make it also hydrogen powered? It is more eco-friendly because no battery.
No, because Porsche powertrain strategy is focusing clearly on three pillars. First is highly efficient and emotional petrol engines. Yeah. The second is performance-oriented plug-in hybrids. Mm-hmm. And the third is cars like that, pure electric cars.
Mm. Also, in my personal experience, there are many misconceptions about the fuel cell technology. So you still have an electric engine and you still have a battery. Sure, the battery is smaller than in a battery electric vehicle, but it is still there. And then to this perfectly well-functioning setup, you add a tank for the hydrogen and a fuel cell. So it does get more complex. What might be the downsides of that?
Yeah, you're correct. Actually, there are up to three of these H2 tanks, 800 bar. It's all about efficiency. If you drive 1 kilometer with an electric car or a fuel cell car, you need three times more energy to do that if you compare it the whole chain, the whole well-to-wheel comparison. The main point is that we don't have hydrogen in nature, so we have to produce it. We have to get rid of the oxygen from water, and that takes a lot of energy.
That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for this important question. See you in the next one. The question for this video is, will it have autopilot? And before you answer, let me just clarify what autopilot is. So it doesn't mean that the car is driving autonomously. It means you have adaptive cruise control, the car stays in its lane and can do lane changes, but your hand needs to be on the steering wheel at all times. Now, what about the Taycan?
We have the same functionality on board. We call it active lane keeping. You can activate it over there. And in combination with lane change assist, you can even do lane changes. Another one is adaptive cruise control that can be activated over there that is doing automatic braking and accelerating.
Usually when you're in a Porsche, you want to do the driving yourself, but maybe you're stuck in traffic or you are on a long road trip, then it's good to have this help from the car. How would you say the driving experience changes?
The systems really do help you to relax. But of course, you as a driver are always responsible to check out the situation and watch the traffic carefully. Yeah. But you can put your hand there on the steering wheel and then you can relax.
So the hand needs to be on the wheel. What would happen if you did take it off?
The car really reminds you very sophisticated to bring back your hand to the steering wheel. Mm-hmm. It's a step-by-step approach. First, there will be a graphic showing you, please put your hands back. Then there will be acoustic signal. Then there will be a brake impulse. And then there will be a nice belt tightened signal, which is quite cool.
There you go. Thank you for the explanation. So the car helps you driving and it reminds you to be responsible. See you in the next video. Bye. You say the emissions are zero. How much damage does lithium mining do? Have you factored that in?
Very important question. First of all, we have to say that the Taycan is locally emission free.
Yeah.
And that really helps if you think about the cities because it improves the air quality. On the other hand, we have to say that authorities do not factor in the emissions of production of the battery. But it's a very important topic and renewable energies is really key to be really zero emission.
And what I've learned is that Porsche uses renewable energies here in Zuffenhausen for the assembly of the Taycan. So zero emissions at the assembly line. What about the supply chain?
Yeah, we have a check in Zuffenhausen and with our suppliers, we are constantly working on reducing the CO2 impact. One example is that we are part of the Global Battery Initiative.
Good to know that Porsche is working on a climate-friendly supply chain. Ben, thank you for this important question and we see you in the next video. Hey Andy, do you like skiing?
Yes, of course I do.
So do I and so does Axel Lund Svindal, two-time Olympic champion. There's a video of him where he drives his Taycan up the mountain to go skiing. Dietmar watched that video and commented, "Hey Axel, how did you get the skis in the car? By the way, great car." So Axel, can you do me the favor? Can you do the demonstration?
Hi Alex, hello Andreas. Sure, nothing easier than that. you do not have space in the trunk, you can easily put a roof box on the Taycan. This is how I get the skis in the car. I hope that was helpful. And by the way, great question, Dietmar.
Voila, his boots. Let's put them into the frunk. The front trunk, AKA frunk.
Yeah, very useful, another cargo space.
That's nice, a second trunk in the front. Dietmar, there you have it. Skis fit in the back and you have some additional space in the front. Guys, thank you for your interest. We hope you enjoyed this. Goodbye for now from Stuttgart-Zuffenhausen.